Hello everyone, welcome to a new Legacy video. I am playing Cephalid Breakfast. This deck is old, it's a very old combo, it's a two-card combo, actually pretty easy. You go turn one Nomad's Anchor or Shuko, turn two Cephalid Illusionist, and then it's a combo because you target the Cephalid Illusionist infinite time, you can even target infinite time with the equipment. You mill your deck, you get Narcomoebas out, you Dread Return, Tassos Oracle, super easy. There's two versions of this deck. One it's this version that top for the Legacy Showcase, so kind of an important tournament that is playing Urza Saga and Slept Through, as well as many counter spells like Daze and Force of Will. Or there is the 80 card version, the one that Javier Dominguez loves and did well in the Four Seasons together with me in June. That was instead with Recruiter of the Guard, more Stoneforge Mystic. It's a little bit slower. Like, the difference is that he said it on the podcast yesterday. Me and him have a podcast. It's called Competitive Magic with the Carnies, together with Anthony Lee. So a little shout out there if you enjoy listening to Competitive Magic stuff. But basically, he said that this version is a fast combo deck. So it's not great against Delver, but it's just a fast combo deck, so it's great against the other matchups, whereas the 80 card version is good against Delver, but it's a little bit worse against the fast combo deck. So it's a little bit, it's just a way different experience than the 80 cards. I want to say this is also easier than the 80 card version because it's a combo deck, so you're going to play faster games. All right, let's begin. Legacy League with Cephalid Breakfast. What else? This video is, of course, sponsored by Channel Fireball and Ultimate Guard. Channel Fireball is now a platform where you can read articles of every sort, as well as you can buy cards using the TCG platform. You can use the affiliate code from me at exclamation mark TCG, and you can buy anything. Any Magic the Gathering card that you need. If you need Step Through, a card you didn't even know existed, that's a few cents, probably. I actually bought the few cards I missed for this deck recently. I didn't have the Cephalid Illusionist and Nomad's Anchor. I had everything else. I don't know if I'll ever play this deck, but I have the cards now. So. And then Ultimate Guard. Best way to protect your deck. All right, Dread Return is in my hand. It's no problem, though, because we can't Cabal Therapy ourselves. We can Cabal Therapy ourselves, put the Dread Return in the graveyard. Or you can always just brainstorm it away and then shuffle and then mill it. So easy. Let's go. I'll start with Ponder. Let me 1 second take a look at the mana. Also, Avira's list plays Baleful Strix. Let me take a look at the mana base. We have two Underground Sea. Okay. Alright, I'll burn one now. I'm looking for Shuko. Stoneforge Mystic is Shuko and this and an extra combo piece. Let's go. Wednesday is your legacy day for locals. Nice. Yeah. I don't play. I mean, I used to also live in a town where we organized the weekly legacy events. It's not that. The legacy scene dried out, it's just my town dried out, so there's no one to play with anymore. I barely have four people to cube with, but I used to also play the weekly legacy. Yeah, that was cool. Prismatic Vista. All right, Island. Okay. Island go. I'm afraid of... Ooh, they're pretty stifled. Maybe they think I am Doomsday. I'm not. I'll go Stoneforge. I should have gone with Fetchling. Because if they force off with this, I would be forced to draw the Tundra, and that was a bad draw. I guess Shuko. Next turn I can win already. This is a two-card combo. You use one creature to target yourself with Cabal Therapy. And then use three to Dread Return. Dread Return banned in Modern. Too powerful for Modern. Too unfair. Tassa's Oracle helped Dread Return a lot. All right, Swamp Island.
Sure.
What? I drew the Tundra regardless? Any Shuffler Truthers out there? Let's go Shuko here. Let's go Cephalids. Do you have it? We have a second one in our hand. What's that? Dades. All right, you dates me. That could be Doomsday, by the way. Speaking of Doomsday. Wait, no, I missed the equipment. All right, I could have dealt one more damage. Let's write it down. One damage miss. I'm holding the spatula because of Brainstorm. That's why I played the Tundra Command. But yeah, this could have been a turn 3 combo. So, very fast. One damage miss noted. But Shaper, at the end, tell me all the damage I've missed. Ooh, is that an Limdun's Vault in upkeep? Ay, ay, ay. I'm feeling the dead here. Feeling of dread or feeling of dead. Limdun's Vault. This is a super old card. It's basically Vampiric Tutor. It's a 2-mana Vampiric Tutor. You can say it isn't. It's also a card that if you export any decklist with this card, Magic Online doesn't recognize the decklist because of the weird U accent. Where's this U accent from? Is it from the north? The north of Europe? All right, they just decided to stop. Okay, sure. They're gonna go do Dark Ritual. Oh, Thoughtseize. Oh no, my Cephalids. You had exploded when you first read this card? Yeah, the key is not to read it. No, it's not. The U? Yeah, unfortunately my Cephalids will say goodbye. Adios, Cephalids. I can still win. I have, of course, I can draw another Cephalid or I can draw Step Through. That can kill me. I don't think I've mentioned why I play Step Through in this deck. It has Wizard Cycling. So you discard it for 2 mana and you pick up the Cephalid. Easy. All right, thoughts is my Cephalid. Yes, indeed. Draw another one. Cabal Therapy. All right, let's begin with a Brainstonks. My hand is bad and didn't get better. It did not get better. Let's Cabal Therapy my opponent. Hey, what do I name? Do I name Doomsday? Sure, right? Do I name Brainstonks? Can they have Brainstorm in hand? I'll name Doomsday. Worst case scenario, then I have it. Show and Tell Emrakul. All right. I kind of want to. I'll tell you what, I'll do it. You'll be dazed by my play here. You'll be like, wow, Mangu, I never saw this play coming. I am going to Cabal Therapy the Emrakul the Aeonstorm so that they shuffle the top of the deck that they set up with the Limdun's Vault. Emrakul the Aeonstorm. Isn't that a great play? Shuffle. And then I also shuffle because my top card. Wait a second, I just realized that the Dread Return was great and I just shuffled it away. I just saw it now. The moment I fetched, I realized it. All right, it's okay. You can take this moment to feel smart and be like, I played better than Mangu. This is your moment. Draw. Va bene. Pass. Hey, imagine if I had a Dread Return there. A big play followed by a punt. Well, the punt was actually like not realizing that that was my line, but that's okay. I can blame it on the fact that I play a different deck every 2 hours. So I got that. I got the excuse covered. Ooh, a ponder could be anything. Well, this is not great, but I have an Urza Saga, which doesn't get anything actually because I have the Shuko down there that I'm gonna draw. I mean, I think I'm keeping this. I don't know. I feel like I could shuffle, yes. But this is big, like it makes 2/4/4, which I'll attack for 6, so I kill them. I kill them very fast here. Linusville? Alright. Yeah. I could have done that. It's okay. Let's keep on playing. I make the game more exciting here for content. The reality, though, is that we're on YouTube. So if you make a mistake, on Twitch and on YouTube, too, if you make a mistake, you are legally required to leave a comment saying, I left after X mistake. Those are the rules. So goodbye to all the people that left. Now, only the true follower remain. We did a nice little... Wait, you don't even pay alive. I'm gonna just index. One mana index. Oh, that is a show and a tell. That is a show and a tell. Hey, unfortunately, I have to go for speech force here. Oh, they just let it resolve. I see. Trigger. Pass, because I want to Arcast Force, maybe. You stayed because you know better than you, so watching makes you feel superior. That's true. It can also be that. You can stay if you... All right, your thoughts is me. A bit. I could have also have pitched days there, but I don't know. I felt like my opponent could have spent 2 mana to do something. What do you put into play? An Emrakul. I lost. Kind of feels bad to lose this game, knowing that I would have won if I had played one game beforehand with this deck. Actually, I haven't lost yet. Right? Because I sacrifice 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh yeah, I lost. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That sucks. Alright. First game to the dealer. What a bad loss. Even if I pitched days instead of force there, I would have won. Alright. Quattro carte. Cardio complete. Does that count really Sabre very much, can it? Teferi actually bounce Emrakul. Maybe I take a Narc Amoeba. I win with creatures anyway. And I take out a land. Because they never fetch basic at planes. Well, let's go. Maybe I don't need 2 Shukos. Why do I need 2 Shukos for? Yeah, non-via list. Yeah, this is a much different list for sure. Okay, we also realized that Dread Return is not a dead card. That's a good thing. It's redundancy. It's extra redundancy. Okay, let's go. Would like to play first? Yes, indeed. Keep. Land go. Land go. Lost the Storm Open, which is the best counter for show and tell because they can't fight it back. Brainstongs. Alright. This is the Kamigawa Island. It's pretty. I like it. Ooh, more counter spells. I'll play Nomazen Core and pass. I have 60 here. If they force me, I'm not gonna force back. Speaking of force, I just drew a force of negation, which is good. Nomazen Core, it's just one way to target your Cephalid, so that's a combo piece. It's like Pest of Might, basically. Blue black. Okay. Force of Negation, not great at protecting your own combo. Put a shuffle their deck. And then shuffles again, maybe. No, they don't shuffle again. We're right. Take a draw. Polluted Delta, not great. I'll play Brainstonks. Let's see. Let's see what I get. This is not great. I for sure have to bottom this. And I guess I'm bottoming a Dread Return. Despite we've seen it was a relevant card earlier. I think it's not great right now. Basically, I just exchanged a Brainstorm for a Philosopher Storm. GG on air. Hey, we're just waiting here. This is a Illusionist Cephalid waiting room. Opponent plays a blue-black show and tell. They won game one. Ooh, I don't have the MTG bot. Wait, MTG bot doesn't work. I guess with the yesterday there was a update, and I guess MTG bot still hasn't updated. So we'll put this little homemade thing that tells you that M00. The league just started. I'm down a game though. You can Yuriko. All right, you got Yuriko. Don't have Kadra in my deck anymore. I think I sided out. Maybe it's a mistake. The next one damage will be dealt to Nomazen Core this turn is dealt to the creature you control. I'll play Stoneforge Mystic. Which doesn't do anything. I'm not going to play it because I have double Flusters or map. I can just block Yuriko with Stoneforge, so it's alright. Real Coleman. Yeah, I think the bot doesn't work. If you're interested in reading the new cards that I play, sorry, the cards that you don't know that I play, you can go exclamation mark deck. That should work. And then you get to see my deck list. Yeah, you can still see my deck list there. You pay three. That's a toxic deluge for two. Well, I can't let that one resolve. So I will flush the stonk it. I don't play days in this. Oh, sorry, I do play 4 days in this deck. I guess. I tried last game as well. I think it was pretty bad. All right, Fluster, Fluster. The Yuriko gets blocked by Stoneforge, so it does nothing. And I would like to draw a Cephalid Illusionist, please. Invece empty cardboard. I wish I had a Hydro Complete in my deck, but I don't. I, in fact, do not, so I'll pass. I want to say the combination of misplays in game one and probably miss sideboard is being lethal in this game. How does this deck compare to the Balustrade Spy? Well, you have lands in this deck, so it's a little bit more solid, I want to say. Don't shuffle. You thoughts is me. I think it's okay to force because Flacestorm protects my own combo. So if I draw a Cephalid, I can fight a Force of Will. Oh, they force my force. Do I want to Fluster? Because they for sure discard Fluster here, 100%. So I think might as well Fluster so that they don't see my hand. I think it's a solid line. Obviously, I need to draw something. The full cards, I can easily have Show and Tell Emrakul now. This is not a control deck. No, not at all. It's a combo deck, yeah. Yeah, exactly. That is the way it goes. I would like to draw a Cephalid or a Step Through. Or a cantrip. There it is. Let's do it. Step through, wizard cycling. Get the Cephalid Illusionist. Play it. They have four cards. Hopefully, I don't have a force blue card. They have force blue card. Pitch brainstorm. Have a bet. And I pass. I still don't want to play Shuko. I feel like, I don't know, bluffing something with one mana is more relevant since Shuko doesn't do anything here. But yeah, Step Through is basically a demonic tutor. All right, that's a show and tell. They put Emrakul, they put Shuko. I have one draw step. Do I want to fetch? I don't think so, because I could draw Brainstorm into two bad cards and the cantrips and then a shuffle. I think it's better to hold it. Draw, boom. We lose. Do I lose? One, two, three. I guess I don't, so I'll play Stoneforge Mystic. Don't have any more Shukos because I set it out. Due, quattro, cinque, sei, sette, otto, nove. So I'll be able to sacrifice everything but this three. Yeah, I guess. I'll say Dades. That force of football. All right, I pass. If they draw a blue card, I'm done. If they. All right, let's annihilate. Six.
Maybe they need you to the Yuriko.
Bro. Oh, so close. All right, GG. Zero, one. But yeah. Leopold Storch. These matches are going fast. A lot of people interested in playing some Legacy. Let's go. Land Ponder. Okay, that's a step through. That's a Force of Will. I like it. I like it. I even have a perfect pitch in Narcomoeba. Step through is the only reason breakfast again. Well, it's 1 year old, so I would say no. People bring breakfast because it top eight at the last showcase, and people play decks that recently do well. It's natural. You can also do well, and I'll play your deck. Draw step through. All right, the top card is a Nomad's Encore. I feel like I just want to go Island Go. And then end of turn, I can tutor up the Cephalid, and then I can try to go off with double counter backup. I think it's cool. They definitely don't see it coming. Maybe they do see coming because they think I'm Doomsday. Maybe I should go more planes. But like the thing is that I don't mind if they wasteland my sea, whereas they do mind if they wasteland my tundra. Right. Let's go. Step through. Wizard cycling. Let's get the Cephalid. Let's get the Tundra. Let's play the Cephalid. Let's play the Nomad Encore. Let's play the Nomad Encore. Yeah, seven cards in hand. They can plow this. If I did the opposite, yeah, it was the same. Oh, I mill three. That's cool. Dates. That force. Pitch Narset. My force. And then we win. Prevent, 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 prevent. I have to do this 15 times. Un, due, tre, quattro, cinque, sei, sette. I guess I'll do it like otto, nove, dieci, undici, 11 times. It's okay. Narcomoeba's art. Oh, was the old. Yes. Yes. Let me Cabal Therapy my opponent here. This just saving Force of Will just to know more of my opponent deck. Caracas, Prismatic Ending, Uhura. Okay. Toodoo. I have zero cards in my deck, and then I try to return the one and only. That says Oracle. On the Tua. All right. Easy game. Now, playing as control. We managed to be double protect on turn three. That's all right. Ma, is this deck supposed to side Berserk against control? Think so. Let's go. But yeah, step through is very good this game. I was able to fetch up my combo piece and endurance proof. Yeah, this combo is endurance proof, funnily enough. Because you can Kabal Therapy your opponent name endurance. If they play endurance in response, then you just go off again. It's cool. It's very cool that his deck is endurance proof. Is this on the draw good? Yes. Do you think Tassa's Oracle is an overall benefit to Legacy? I don't really think about those things. I play the card they give me. I'm not a card philosopher. Should I Kabal Therapy or should I hold it for my combo? I could just name a Ponder. Or a Brainstorm. I'm gonna name Ponder. No. Okay. Go. Should I just land the Cephalidir? It dies to the Prismatic Ending card, which isn't great. I think it's fine. I'll play it, yes. And then I pass. I can come out therapy, but I don't want to do it. And they pass. I'll attack. Attack all. And then what do I do? I kind of want to play Teferi. What if I actually sacrifice myself a little to discard Force? Is that a cool play? Maybe it is, because I need to keep Force for Surgical. Well, I guess if I have Teferi in play, Surgical does nothing. So I can just go Teferi, they force, I force. But the problem is that if they have a blue card, they can flush to my force. I think I'm going to Kabal Therapy. Adios, Cephalid. I'll name Forca de Volontade. Ooh, they cannot flush to my Cephalid. That's not a smart play, maybe. All right, I go force, pitch, fluster. Then I think I'm fine. I think I'm actually required. It's requ I'm required to play the Cephalid, otherwise I have to force the Surgical, which I don't love. All right, yeah, let's change plan. It was still a fine play. Go ahead. At the end, I think it played out fine. I mean, if I could have Surgical in response, then I need to force the Surgical. That could have flustered the force of him. All right, I think I saved myself because I didn't Surgical the Cephalid. I mean, I could have gone like a beatdown planner or a saga. It's not that I lose, but yeah, that was pretty funny that we got saved there. All right. Teferino, come help me. Da-da-da-da-da. Hello, Physici MTG. Are you the player I net decked? Good thing you showed up around two, because I punted away round one in an awful manner. Okay, they forced my Teferi. You know, I really want to defend my Teferi here. I think Teferi is great. I mean, it's tough Surgical, so. And now it's just a Shuko waiting room or Nomad Encore. Easy. Should be easy. Ponder. All right, I'll let the room resolve. I said to keep 2 days because like that deck plays 1 billion 3-drops, so I think days is great. You plow my sword. Okay, first let me mill 3, and then does it. That's a picture of days. Nor is a saga. Exclamation mark deck, you can see my list. 3 years of saga in the deck. Buongiorno, Gigi. Draw. Brain stonks. Woo! Nomads. Let's go Saga, trigger, let's go Shuko, and then equip. Do I auto-yield this? Sure. And then you can equip again. It's a weird rule, I don't know why it's this way, but you can equip a creature that's already equipped. GG, 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 GG. All right. After throwing out the window the first match, we are back on track with the Cephalids. But look at this opponent. I don't think I've ever seen a queue run this fast. Huh? The Magic Online queues, you find opponents so fast. It feels like it's edited. It's not. It's all live. In case you're watching this after. I'm finding a point in 1 second. How many players are active in Legacy in this in the queues? Sorry. 431. It's not that many. All right, spells and lands, keep. Yeah, I mean Legacy is great. People don't play that much in paper because it's super expensive, but it's, you know, together with Modern, the best format. Unfortunately, price tags, it's what decides how fun are Magic formats these days. All right. Well, they have a Bloodstained Mire. That to me means Entomb. I'm feeling hot with this Cabal Therapy. I'm feeling hot. I'm not gonna name Entomb. I'm not gonna name Entomb. If they had it, I would have cast it first. But what kind of hand do they keep that doesn't have Entomb? And they just goes land go. Can I just go with a safe brainstorm? I don't think you can never go wrong with a brainstorm. Boom. Oh God. Okay, I would have never guessed, so it's all right. Yoko. It's been like that for 20 years? Legacy? No way. It's not been like that for 20 years. Five years. I remember selling Underground Sea for two or three Baneslayer Angels. I remember that. Maybe like even one or two Baneslayer Angel. Remember winning a tournament. First prize was an Underground Sea, and I traded it for. For 20 packs of Scars of Mirrodin. If Gear is in the chat, he can testify that that's actually what happened. Actually, Pox of Scars of Mirrodin are quite expensive. The problem is that I drafted them, so it was, you know, they just vanished. All right, do I daze this? Because, like, I think I do. My opponent hand is not great, and I don't know. I mean, obviously, I can get better. I can get better target for daze, but. And you don't have lands. All right, let's go. I think I'm making a weird play, but I want to go Urza Saga go here. Let's do it. Amulet Way. I don't know if this is correct. Bubble. Lion's Eye Diamond. Attenzione. Lion's Eye Diamond unlocks the Mox Opal. I know every other card almost, so I think I want to force this. Let me think. Yeah. What's the logic behind the Urza Saga? Because I can get Ashuko in 2 turns there. Let's see what they do. They have a pretty clunky hand. Trigger. Blue card, please. Any blue card. That's not Tassa's Oracle. Va bene. Wait, actually, it doesn't. It's not great. Oh, come on. I can't combo now. Va bene, that's okay. That's okay, right? I can still go Cephalid now, next turn fetch Shuko, and then cast. I just, it doesn't matter. Go. Bonjour, Black Mane. I hope my opponent is still non-functional. They pass, and next turn I win. So I can't play Force Pitch. I mean, unless I'm dead. Unless I'm dead. Bubble again. So they know I have an Archimede by hand. I pass. Sure. Draw. Draw. Float colorless. Pick up a Shuko. Play land. And then I will target my Cephalid here. Mill 3, they concede. All right. Cool. I can't make a token with Saga. I don't have 3 mana to make a token with Saga. Bene, bene, bene. So I'm playing against a deck that wasn't very functional. Well, I guess I'll go for the combo package. Maybe Teferi's bad in this matchup. I don't think I need a second Shuko. Well, this thing should be good. Let's get back one Archimede. One Soulforge Mystic, one land. Vamos. Yeah, I'm gonna keep Kadra this time because I played against Shuntai round one. I didn't keep Kadra, and I mean, I think I would have won if I had Kadra. All right, that's a mulligan. That's a keep. Whoa, look at that. Perfect, perfect mulligan here. The perfect mulligan here. A 2-turn combo with force backup. We have two Narcomoebas in our deck. Before, yes, only one, but I could cast the first one, and then I would have had three creatures in play. The Cephalid plus two Narcomoeba. Let's go. Land. Suko. Go. Do-do-do. I wish, I hope I don't have to play Daze this turn. If they put it, we'll see. They pass. Well, I'm going. Oh, I can't combo. I drew Narcomoeba. Yeah, right? All right, I guess I can't combo. You went on a date with an Italian girl last week, and she said in her town they eat horse meat. Yeah, horse meat. I never personally ate it, but yeah. It is indeed a thing. All right, I think I'm casting Narcomoeba this time and not. Yeah, I'm casting Cephalid. Maybe they concede again. Like, they conceded earlier. Why wouldn't they concede again? This deck seems a bit inconsistent. What? I just won on turn two. How can you say it's inconsistent? No, I said it out when Narcomoeba. I mean, usually you win with Nemazen Core. Twitch chat says deck is inconsistent. Literally wins on turn two with Force of Will Demand. Oh, but well, actually, blah 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 blah. Come on, you don't see how that's different from any animals. Well, then you can say the same for dogs and bats and things like that. But we will not talk about that right now. I wanted just to double check that, yes, indeed, you still feel superior. Yeah, that's the goal. Who cares? A win is a win. Yeah. I couldn't combo. Well, I could combo. I comboed. I played a card and they conceded. Also, I mean, I said it on Narcomoeba. Maybe that's not a thing you're supposed to do. And also, I drew it. That was like, this was the only draw that was bad. Normally, plays four Narcomoebas, right? Yeah. Normally, maybe that. It's a fast deck, at least. What happens if you draw Dread Return? Well, in theory, you can Cabal Therapy yourself. In practice, you can also just mill a bunch, pass the turn, and then the next turn, Dread, tap 4 mana, Dread Return. Maybe 80 card is better. Maybe, I don't know. You draw Narco and Dread less. Yeah, but you also draw the Cephalid less. Not a great hand. I could mulligan, but I'm not. Maybe add the Phantasmagorian. Well, this is competitive Magic. Usually, you want to add the least possible amount of win condition. Actually, we had a talk yesterday about the new Jeskai Breach card. Just reducing win condition is the key. Dread Dark Ritual. Mishra's Bubble. Wait, is this the same opponent as earlier? No. Dark Creature Mishra's Bubble. This is already a six. What's the six? Dread Return? Wishclaw Talisman. What do they wish for? Also have Brainstorm. You can say it's a mulligan to six. You can. Okay. Mind's Desire for my opponent. on a common print. And they also have the Veil of Summer, which is very annoying. Imagine printing a 3-mana Mind's Desire in a format where Mind's Desire is banned. What actually, Mango doesn't win the same turn. Okay. Go. 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 Go, go, go. Great chat impersonation today. Yeah, right? I can't foresee all my chat's reaction. Does Relay see Pauper play? It doesn't. If you look at the most recent Pauper lists, you'll find 0 copies of Galvanic Relay. Opponent starts with Veil of Summer. Do I play Daze? Daze Undoing. But it's a common. Yeah, no, sorry, it was a joke. It's banned. It's banned. That's why it doesn't see play. I wanted to take a long way to a joke, but allora, they have a Veil of Summer. What if I let this resolve? They go. Well, ad nauseam, they kill me. Maybe I should just start with a Brain Stonks. We should start with the Brain Stonks. Brain Stonks. And then I go Forca de Volontade. You missed a Relay in Feldonkain Pauper Storm deck. Yeah, there was like 1 week where Galvanic Relay was everywhere. That Chromoxer Kane. Feldonkain, yeah, because you would get through your deck all the time. They pitched Brainstorm from hand, so they still have a Brainstorm there. They tap 3 mana for what? Oh, they tap the Wish Call Talisman. All right, give me the card. You don't know why is Mind's Desire in Legacy? Because they made the ban list like 15 years ago, and God forbid they unban a card in Legacy. It's my turn. It's my turn. And actually, I have a pretty good card in my hand. Wishclaw Talisman is no joke in this deck. I will fetch up a card. Draw. I'll play Illusionist. Go and next turn we tutor up the Shuka. Squirrels. Actually, they banned Squirrel first and then Galvanic Relay, funnily enough. Because Squirrel in Pauper comboed with First Day of Class. First Day of Class also combos with some other cards, but you know, that's not a story. The only Storm legal cards in Pauper are Weather the Storm, Reaping the Graves, and Scattershot, and a card that gets lands. All right. I want to say that the Epic Storm decks did not put up a strong performance. Let's put it this way. They did not put a strong performance. There were a combination of can't really interact with me and not not very good combo decks. But, you know, maybe sample size, blah, blah, blah. Is there a reanimator deck in Pauper? Exhum is legal, but it's not a good... Alright, this opponent isn't going to make what my previous opponent did. And it's actually going to let me go through the combo. Sorry, you want to see the deck. You can see it on twitch.tv/AndreaMengucci live right now! Exclamation mark! I want to say. Getting some free advertisement, shall we? Gotta hustle, exactly. I will play a Cabal Therapy. What's your opinion on a good budget deck to start Legacy? Hello, Sabronis. Budget and Legacy, it's very hard to be together. There's a deck called Mono Blue 8-cast, which I really like and has no reserve list card. I forgot that I was game one. I thought it was game two. That's why I told my opponent to come watch the stream. I shouldn't have done it. I should not have done it. All right, but let's side in some random seven cards, taking out the usuals. Do I want to take out Narcomoeba? This opponent, I mean, they might concede next game if I combo, so I'll take it out. Although, if you're watching the stream, Anadron and Narcomoeba, they know they shouldn't comp, they shouldn't concede. You better win on turn two? Yeah, I know. Well, that's okay. No, I really thought it was game two and I won game one because I just played against that deck before. My bad. I'm in a good mood today. Yeah, I'm in a good mood today. The weekend is approaching. It's Thursday, right? Today. Cazzo, today's my girlfriend's birthday. Porca puttana boia. Keep. No, this is not gonna go on YouTube. I'll cut this part. Let me actually write it down so I don't forget. Cut after round four, game one. Okay. Game number two, I'm on the draw. Let's go. Mm-hmm. What do I do here? What's the combo deck? I think I'm just gonna go Nomad Zencore. This hand isn't great, to be honest. Am I going to live? It is certainly. Wait, did I not sideboard? No, I did. Okay, good. Hello, Doge. How's it going? By the way, hopefully things will go well. So, to answer, after the cut, maybe you might have missed something, but somebody in the chat asked me why was I in a good mood, and I said because today is a special day, but I forgot why, and because it was my girlfriend's birthday, but I forgot. My mood, no, that it was a special day, that I had like a nice evening planned, but I forgot. So then, basically, I remembered because of who was the person that made me remember it. Was it Crezoro? Was it you? But yeah, anyway, thank you so much, Crezoro, for making me remember that there was something special going on today. Tasso's Oracle. Does my girlfriend watch the stream? Of course not. Never admit I forgot. I mean, I obviously forgot. I like wish her, good morning and things like that. And sent her a picture of my niece, so I also missed the point of damage now. Right, how about I take the cadre? I think I'm taking the cadre here. Yeah, no sugar. No blackmail, no secrets here. I remembered, I told everything. I don't know what. Yeah, I know. Yeah, there was something weird going on. She hasn't responded. She hasn't responded yet. I want to hope that she doesn't. I even called her, and then I sent her a video of my niece singing "Happy Birthday." Kind of using my niece now. I'm sorry. Sorry, niece. Sorry, Bianca. On the other end, your opponent doesn't do anything. I only drawers and sagas. I guess we're going to beat down here. Child labor. Attack. What? Chain of Vapor. I don't want to sacrifice the land. I'm already sacrificing this land soon. When did she message me that I forgot? At 9 a.m. Just right after I went live. That's diabolic. Go ahead, last minute gift prepared. No, I have a gift. I have a gift. I'll show it to you. I have a gift here. A little behind. I also booked the cake. I booked the cake for later. MTG, stop asking MTG. No, it's not. That's a diamond. Okay. Open it up. We want to see. Oh, I agree, Lee. I mean it. Alright, you cast the spells next turn. I just want to draw Cephalid and get over with this. What is the opponent playing? The Epic Storm, it's called. Oh, she messaged me. Oh, it's okay. It's all good. It's all good. It's all good. It's all good, chat. It's all good. She liked the video of my niece. She said, "Thank you." It's all good. It's all good. It's all good. Bene così. Vamos. Allora, let's play a ponder. Shall we? Probably I shouldn't. No, I shouldn't play a ponder. Narcomoeba Cephalid Illusionist. I wish I could cast it. I wish I could cast it. Free child labor coming in clutch. Ah, bene così. I'll draw Narcomoeba. To pitch Tessa's Oracle here, that sucks. I want to shuffle. I'll play Urza's Sagra. I'll make a token. Mango thinking it's safe. I'm safe. It's okay. Man, Crezoro, you're the best. You're the best. What would I have done without you? Attack, attack, go. Go. Allora, so they start with Veil Samurai counter, and then I counter again, and then I don't have Tassa's Oracle in my hand, and all I have to do is beat down with Shuko's. Yeah. 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 And not this one. Oh, wait, this is from hand? Oh wow. I actually lose here because this is from hand. They can crack these and cast these. Yeah, I lose. Because they crack lines like that, because these are exiled, so they can crack these lines like diamond. Wait, three black? Huh. Seven spell? Yeah, it's just easy with it's wait, what does this do? The next one damage will be dealt to Nomad Core. Nothing. Yeah, I'm just dead to tendrils. Your strength is yeah. All right, GG. GG opponent. I don't think I could have played around this, so that's okay. Almost. Maybe I don't want Kadra. That's fine. They went. Kadra. My thing with Kadra is that I give so many counter spells. I might need a B plan. I don't know. Any Murktide today? Yeah, tomorrow. Tomorrow, play Blur and Murktide. Before Tessa's Oracle, this deck didn't. wasn't great. Let's just say that. Every deck before Tassa's Oracle weren't great. Okay, I have a combo. It's a little bit convoluted because this one can get Cephalid, this one can get Shuko, but can get there. I guess I can also just go Saga turn one. No, I want to go the Blast and Daze. I'll go Land Go. You're learning a lot from your Murktide videos? Yeah. There's gonna be one every Sunday. That's the goal, at least. They always get a good viewership, so I'll keep on doing it. Okay, you have two cards, you pass. I'll take a turn. I think I just go Saga Go. Oh, not come ever, come sempre, va bene. I'll go Saga Go. So when I keep the Blue Elemental Blast up, end of turn, I can go step through for the Cephalid. And then we can. I mean, we could combo off, except I don't because I. Wait, did I side out Arcaviva again? I did! Oh no, Mango! That's okay, actually. I still win next turn. I still win next turn here because I have Stoneforge to sacrifice. It's all good. It's all good. We got it. We got it covered. Don't you worry. Okay. Oh, do you pass? Do they have interaction with my combo? I hope not. End of turn, Demonic Tutor. Untap. Trigger. Play Cephalids. Pass. Card complete. And these draw steps are not being nice to me. Play Cephalid or play Stoneforge? I think I'll play Cephalids. Play Cephalids, pass. How to mill yourself by targeting Cephalid a lot. It's okay. Stoneforge will be the third creature. It's all good. Abrupt Decay. All right, I'll mill three. Another Cephalid is there. Do we make a construct turn three? Hey, we'll see. Now I don't have any more. I don't have any more my creature. You passed. Draw. Hydro Blast. I'll play a Stoneforge. Don't have any target. No. I keep, I guess. And pass. Is there anything in the new set that will shake up Legacy a bit? Not really, but they added two Legacy, two cards that I'm excited to try. It's the White Initiative creatures. You already buy them. White Plume Adventurer and the other guy. White? No, not yet. But yeah, you'll have the White Plume Adventurer and the Seasoned Engineer that I think are good in Legacy. All right, so if I go Cephalid, They have to abrupticate a Shuko. I go cephalids, they have to abrupticate a Shuko. Because they can't abrupticate the cephalid. No, that's not true. They can, obviously. All right, then. I'm just passing because I don't want to tap out. Although I have Cadre complete end of turn. More initiative? Yeah, initiative. Everyone's favorite mechanic. Who doesn't like a good old card that doesn't say what it does on the text box? Who doesn't like having to know 17 different things? Oh, did you know that during the game you can check the dungeon informations? Did you know that? And look at this! Here's the Undercity. Do you not know what it does? Magical and Gachi covered. Oh, they start with Rite of Flame. I think I countered this. Wanna have nothing to read? I wanna read something while your opponent's thinking. Right click, view dungeon information. Boom! You can get something to read. You can put a sticker on your dungeon trap card. Oh, yeah. There is, in fact, a trap card, Dark Ritual. Undercity is a new dungeon. By new, I would say this summer. It came out this summer, the Undercity. But you can only go there with the initiative. You can't go there with the, like, Acerak. The Acerak dungeon, it's a different type of dungeon. Don't you worry. Three, oh, no, we can't do that. We got Hydro Blast for Dades. You got Veil of Summer. All days. They pay, so they have one black mana, and they resolve a Burning Wish. Can't be countered, you draw a card. Oh, they Dark Ritual and Dark Ritual. Oh, I die. Congratulations, opponent, you have won. After saying that you didn't put up a good performance, you killed me. Maybe I would have won if I just went a cephalid in my turn. But I didn't. I, in fact, lost. Alright. I want to say we are 2-2, but we could have won both the games that we lost. Both the rounds that we lost. So that's funny. Maybe they didn't have the cane and we would have won. Exactly, yeah. Yeah, maybe. Maybe, but, you know. Sometimes when playing a game of Magic, you decide to take lines that you regret, and some other times you never know if it was right. Yeah, they didn't have the K because they played their whole cards. I would have won. They casted every card of their hand. But I don't know. There was a lot of choices in the game. Unfortunately, my mind is a little bit fried at the beginning of this game too, as you might have seen. Buongiorno, Pivo. Buongiorno, Build or Burn. Thank you for the games. Round number 5, we got a hand of magic cards. Keep. Tassa's Oracle, chilling. This is why playing Win Condition is bad. Whereas my opponent doesn't play Win Condition in the main deck, they're Burning Wish. Much better. Imagine if this Tassa's Oracle wasn't actually a Tassa's Oracle, but was like, I mean, it's a different example. But of course, like whenever you can build your combo deck that doesn't actually have awful cards, like, you know, Tassa's Oracle, Emrakul, stuff like that, it makes it, this is better. You can Living Wish for Oracle, yeah, but you can't quite Living Wish, Dread Return the Living Wish. So. I think I'm gonna draw the Force of Will. Actually, Force of Will, like, I can't pitch Tassa's Oracle, I think I'm gonna shuffle. Yeah. If I had a different blue card, sure, I would have drawn Force of Will. I think it's always good to have Force of Will in Legacy. Forest go. Nice draw. Should I go for... should I go for Cephalid here? I think so. Force is never bad. Well, but let's say I would have drawn Force and Land. It would have been terrible. Whereas I drew 2 random cards, I think it's better. Basically, I can't pitch Tassa's Oracle. That's the problem of only playing one. I go Stoneforge for Shuko. I'll play Shuko. I'll equip my Cephalid. Please don't abrupt decay me. Taiga. Is that a punishing fire? Stomp, also known as Stonk. Victory! Woohoo! Yeah. How do you get rid of Tassa's Oracle? You can Kabbalah Therapy yourself. You can Kabbalah Therapy yourself and win from there. We try to turn Tassa's Oracle. Okay, I'm playing against Gruul cards. A famous archetype. Rule Adventures, yeah, all the way from the Stomping City Chalice deck. That's a great idea, Maze's End. I didn't think about it. Should I cut something else? Ah, it's too late. Yeah, maybe. I brought in Force of Negation because usually Stomp decks are, I don't know, a little bit unfair, like Blood Moon type of decks. I didn't think about Chalice, but yeah. All right, let's go. Forest again. Arbor Elf. I feel like they might have a Blood Moon now, so I'll play Hydro Blast. Is this deck a meme? My deck? No, my deck is a competitive deck that top 8 of the Legacy Showcase. The Legacy Showcase. My opponents? Maybe they're memeing here. Maybe they just... Yeah, it's not by 4-drop now. What is it? K Caves of Chaos Adventures? Are they getting to the Undercity? Are they Minsk and booing? Kiora? Is your favorite breakfast the cephalid breakfast? Yeah. All right, that's it. They said no more spells. All right, I'll take it. You're up. E terra ce l'abbiamo. My cabal therapy, of course, cannot be played since I have literally no clue of what can I name, so I'll pass. Cabal therapy for Cavalier Thorn? Yeah, that's probably what I have to name here. Oh, echo the Goreclaw, the Terror of Colossisma. Okay. Let's not judge your opponent deck since my hand loses to a draft deck right now, please. My deck was already pretty bad and it drew two lands in a row, so. Step through. I could have named Goreclaw. Yeah. I'll play my Demonic Tutor end of turn. Get a Cephalid. Draw. Urza Saga. Alright. Go. Pioneer deck? No, you don't play Goreclaw in Pioneer. Four. Ulgar Troll. Okay, this is a Pioneer staple, I have to say. And also, the Ulgar Troll got a cost reduction by Goreclaw of two colorless. This is a great combo. You go Goreclaw first, and then Ulgar Troll only costs three green. All right, they go to combat. Cosa fa adesso questo? You pump the Ogre Troll. Oh, until, okay, this is pumped until end of turn. Bene, well, I still don't have any play available, so I'll take a draw. Do I feel like naming something with Cabal Therapy? No, I don't actually. I'll pass. I'm not dead, right? Why is Ogre Troll's all black right now? I don't know what magical line it has in plans, but I'll pass. Are they in the wrong queue? No, they have Taiga in the deck, so they're certainly in the right queue. They stomp me. Aspetta, is this lethal now? Undici? Does this pump itself? I think I have to Hydro Blast this. Because that's 11 damage in play. Do you think they have Embercleave? Oh! Oh wow, I activated the trap card. Okay. Go. I'm still not dead here. I can make a chump blocker with the Sagra. And just chump block. Oh no, this thing is trample. Oh, okay, have I lost? I'm dead on board, if that at all. I'm dead on board, chat. Shifting Ceratops. We are officially dead. I think this is good enough to screenshot. What do you think? Haste. Maybe they don't kill me. They do. Congratulations, opponent. You have succeeded in winning this game of Legacy. Hello. Let's just resume our main deck. I don't think I need to sideboard. I guess I have Source of Life Shears in my deck though. It's probably better than Teferi. No, vabbè, Teferi non è male in realtà. Teferi is not bad. Maybe one Teferi is bad. No, aspetta, this is good. Alright. Then I cut down on Archimedes? I don't know. Whatever. Draw good end. Alright, keep. Which modern deck is easily upgraded to Legacy and NTGO? Blue or Murktide? You can add Forest Days, Wasteland. Actually, you lose a Ragavan. I'm not sure how big of a bargain it is. I thought we'd ponder, looking for the. No, not these. Thank you, though. Appreciate it. Cephalid? We need Green Lantern Blast. Utopia Sprawl. That's a good start. They're naming a color. Red, okay. Draw. Teferino. Va bene. Let's go for a Brainstorms. Oh, the Narcomoebas. I'm actually keep I think I'm keeping one Narcomoeba here though. Yeah. I have only two Narcomoebas in my deck. Sorry, I have only one Narcomoeba in my deck, but I think that should be enough. Because I have Nomads plus Cephalid plus one Narcomoeba, and that's enough. Goblin? Yeah, Goblin gets better because of the Goblin Lackey. Cindervines. Sure. This doesn't do much. Draw. Not bad. Cephalid. Prevent. Prevent. Trigger. 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 Ziggurat. Ezzakkaday. 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 And that's the win! I got my entry feedback. Couldn't be happier, honestly. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, my girlfriend, for supporting me during this win. I wouldn't have done without her. I want to thank Cresoro for remembering my girlfriend's birthday as well. And yeah, that's it. That's it. I will cherish this treasure chest with you, chat, by not open it.